Any ngadin la ya de kanza che ke lam nyam zal lem par sa chi chi chag yor kanza che ke lam ramba na jing go ne nyam le na ya de che chag yor en de yin de de la tambo ndor tin da je che na ba ni yong ge yor es tambo ndor tin te song yong ge yor tham cho nam da da ni chim bi ko song do ene de song ya de ta zob san je thob thap de ne cho do chur ba de san chok sem re es Then the Nadink Nalone Tambo Sancho same the song Yung Yure. Any Dani Chimbuka song Yure, Dani Chimbuka Layate, then Rank Le Yedam Lagom Yate song Yung Yures, then the Tambo Nitere.
The Fivefold Path of Mahamudra is the stages of the path for one. A person to practice, so it is a step-by-step practice which can be practiced by one person in one session. And so if it is practiced in one session, then the root text summarizes it in the following way. The supreme skillful means, the embodiment of the pure bodhicitta being. So the supreme skillful means here, that is the first point of bodhicitta. The skillful means, or the supreme skillful means, is the supreme method to attain enlightenment, which is bodhicitta. And then the embodiment of the pure bodhicitta being. So this pure being here refers to the second point of the fivefold path, that is to visualize oneself in the form of the yidam.
Yibyin nomen tajar namkewe son de tasik chake yore. En te son de tal lama son yungu yore. Yibyin nomen laya de. Gendo tamche yung yibyin nomen tawa de lama rez. En te ngading nalo ni sumba chake yore. Lama gomya de. Tien jo la teni saja chenpo gomya de son yungu yore. Yiba de la ransom tripen ta tamche da trawe. Teni osar saja chenpo. Osar saja chenpo laya de ya gandre che la shiga yore lana. Any your yurchi nis me par top low. Zimbu namdo to so pa charsoma. The reche la saja chimbo lago yores. Any tegan yola yang tasiki doa, remi chiji maze rinchin teresongo yore. Tega any nading nalone moate song yungo yore. Teni gave tsawa tzo, simjin jindon do moa. Te in the telang adin sitanga songo doa. Sancho sem. Any rang le yadam gla gomya then tegen jola lama any saja chimbo tang hoa se tene nga sung go yore nga din la ya che nga din la ya de saja chimbo ke yin la che cha go yore saja chimbo singen ra se nga din mi ne mi mi yin sung go yore lam nga din ge go ne nyam sa ma lam wa yin na saja chimbo de make me be singen na yin re se Ini ngadain laya te meidan tempat na yang cakap yore so anda tak tentu tertop komat nama kita tentu sungguh yore. Ini te yang te dorti yang cita te oleh jeshe di sebagai yang cerita anda kong wang ke kaps te ni rumbo cikit tada te ngadain ke to wang ke kaps coba jitin sungguh ke song jawa ke ngadain ke tonggor laya cik yore topeng gor ini te casang cik kacang song yore. Nordi jiktin na kazan wang ge kapsa song yore ta tren ta dan de ma jeshe de shege yin chi
and then on the next page 132 then the third point to practice is the guru devotion the wish fulfilling jewel within limitless sky so that refers to the guru who is like a wish fulfilling jewel So we practice the guru devotion. And then the fourth point is Mahamudra, the ongoing river of non-duality. And so this luminosity, Mahamudra, beyond subject-object duality is the fourth point. And so the this luminosity, Mahamudra, is the nature of the mind that is free from grasping at thoughts of ideas or perception of a subject-object duality. So it's to rest within a non-dual state of mind. And then last is the dedication where virtue is the inexhaustible precious treasury. So the virtue accumulated is dedicated for the benefit of sentient beings. And so these are the five steps in the fivefold path of Mahamudra. So it is bodhicitta, it is the yidam chakra samvara, it is guru yoga, it is Mahamudra and dedication. And these are the five branches that belong to the practice of the Mahamudra. And it is said by the past Mahasiddhas, they have said that to practice without the practice Mahamudra, without this fivefold path, is like a blind lion. And so if you practice with the fivefold path, then it is like having eyesight. So that is just the summary of the fivefold path, and later on after that, the explanation. So yesterday when Rinpoche gave the empowerment on the fivefold path of Mahamudra, the Dharma empowerment, in that empowerment, there were, for each of those five steps, those five parts, there was one song of realization by Jigten Sumgon, a brief verse. So Rinpoche mentioned that yesterday, and so today we will explain that more thoroughly.
And it that Jeshe Tela Gonzo Chinga Yoba Namjinani, that Tambo Sancho Semte Song Yung Yore. Sancho Semtela Samchin Zedin Kanyam Rinchin Sem Songdua. Then it Sambada Ninje, Sancho Sem Jikani Lave, then it Jiram Dan Zoram, Kang Gomba Tela, then it Kandar. State of same tela namka tar che me par chur sem sung yore tendu ko lo jang go yore se pen ngarang so lam nga ke tini chiram da zoren nyamne se ben ka la sancho sem go lo jang go yore sancho sem la ya te ene kande chile she go yore lam na simji pa ne yindon ser zo ne simji yindon lu mi pa che da ene yanda zo bu sancho do zo ne yanda ba zo bu sancho ji kompan thum do go lo yo de wa ene tendu ke mi pa ni da den ba che la sancho ko sem la go yore ते सांचो सेम द कावानी चेके योर लामना ते ने निंजे लेते ने चेके योरे ऐसे निंजे द कावानी चेके योर लामना सांबा ने चेके योरे ते ये ने ऐने ची थम चेके चावन डावो ते ता सांबा लतो द योवा ते ने सोंग नांग के योरे तादान दे साम दा निंजे सांचो सेम दे तादान दे के नालो ला जेशे सी के योमारे दौड़ी चे मातो कहीं शिवा ये ने खर्चा कोंग लांडे ऐने सांचो सेम दे जा चे बोचे शिचा योरे ने कोंग ला Tatan din a door temba no mado, jejin jeba shiga yomares. Any gandar naranzo, Sancho sem ke tisimbo goni, gave tsawa karesawa in a young, any te yindon hogo yore, gets a country seva in a te yolon hoaji yungu yore, te in the tatan din a tele canzon, tenjor tengin rows on the Sancho sem dang, any tonin hinge yerme bring on hogo res on hoaji song yore. Ding hoate, Sancho sem take a serag hoaji chaka yore mato young. Nadin nalog hoate chaga yomares. Sancho sem korang ke sedak hoachi chaga yores.
Nothing over Maria.
Nadin nalog tanga lang hoachi yora. Ting hoat in jolla yung yore.
Tedong over shame.
Ding hoate Sancho sem ke yen larua. Ting nadin nga nani ching hoareva. Ting hoat in de chaga yomare.
So first is the first point is bodhicitta. So the precious bodhicitta mind of love and kindness is as vast as infinite space. We engage in the following practices of the development and completion stages. First on the basis of the motivation of bodhicitta, of loving kindness, compassion, and bodhicitta. So it says the mind is immeasurable like space. Here actually the point on bodhicitta is actually just mentioned really briefly. It is not really explained in detail here, and that is because before in this text we already talked about bodhicitta more extensively. So therefore, since we already covered that, it is only mentioned briefly here. So it's like a summary. And so then once we have cultivated bodhicitta, then whatever virtue we practice with bodhicitta, then in the end also must be dedicated for the benefit of others, for the purpose of others. And that is from within a state inseparable of inseparable emptiness and compassion. And so this kind of dedication here is like a branch of bodhicitta. So it's a motivation, and then also it becomes a dedication. So this dedication here is not the dedication that is explained as the fifth step later on. So this dedication here is just part of the bodhicitta motivation.
Chi tambo de sanchu sem de song ne ta chi ni ba de song yong yo re chi ni ba de yadam ji la gomba song yo re ene yadam ge la gomba de ta tsa se ge na lo la ta dan de bu ye ge na lo ni ja dan sum ji so song ri do xo le ene tsa se de ya bu ngi seng go yo re tsa se de ha ko song wa ye na e de xia lo de de xie de so lo de de sa ji go de wo dang ta de wo cha ge yo re wa de ni tsa se de nge par de lo go yo re pe pin do yo re tsa se de mang se lo na ene tsatsek de nalo la ta doni lenchin diso junam ton song yude te ke tonda te ma o lan ja she she yung go yure ene sancho je sem tel song la ne song do ta la la ya te kawani song are lam ne sancho sem ni song de yure si sancho sem ga ran zo re si yadam ga la la ya te ene te la te ngar me pa che ta ta sa do thau yung wa ten de ma re si Do ni rang yin ji yong su trupa song gu yore Ya do ma ni ngarang su sem ka rang yin kang yin ba te la la trup de yore si Trupa ting tang si Yini tenpo ngobo hling chi si ne de yuwa De te ni la te ni ngar la yin ba te ngarang su ngom ma si ne Ngarang su tata sosi chi wo tamar pa la gu yore La ngarang su ke Ya do ma ni ne de wa sem ka rang yin de la yin ba si yon ne ka la Yini te yin de Te yin ba la yin ba to Hako lagu yore, la yinpa la yinpa hako si. Eni la yinpa la yinpa la hako tuku yomare. Gare si hako go yomare la na ngarang so. Eni ngin gandar ngin ta dripa la soba mangbo chi nyomobu dripa tang shizu dripa la soba dripa teta ke dremne. Eni ngarang so la yinpa la hako tuku yomare. Tendu yindi la yinpa la hako war sibe tabla. Eni ta chi ye dingo go yore, song yong go yore, chi ye. Ini cikyo kare dingo yur lamna, ini sancho lezong tini sancheng ta sondwa. Tengin di cikyo goni nyamlin si gore si la gombe ne kala ta drapa tu so pa panya ke pang ne cikyo dan dembo goni nyamlin si gore si yadam ke la gombe yala. Ta tangbo te sancho ke sem, la laya te sancho ke sem ngani songa yin di sancho ke sem gongo go yure. Ini Nipa te la ngajar ting sung yore Chirtan Pecha yin ke kapsa sewa yin na ngajar ting la ya te Eni njolu lep yung yore te tata ndi tzatsik nrotan kani yung yore Tzatsik nrotan Tzatsik te kani sen nyinga nro se yore wa Eni sancho le zong ting ne zong di tzik nro dewa le ting Eni ngajar ting la ya te tambo lep yung yore Tzatsik nrotan ke kani Jiyong ni ngarang su nyamlin siwe nekab lan di koram ten di na yin yung ku yomari di tzatsik di nyinga ke khani lew yung di teni di na yi sewa yin di tek si tab diya yore tzatsik di nrotang la di yin di ta ngajar ten ba laya di chak yore si ngajar ten laya di teni ranyi la mingpa la la gomya ten di chak yomari ranyi ye duma ni la yinpa la yinpa si ne eni tel ngajar ten bo zong go gore si pen ngarang su tada La ta karen reji nyamni sewa yin da, jin reze nyamni sewa yin da, ni ngarang su zog te jin reze yin pa gom go go yore. Ka yin sen da, teni jin reze ki rang yin te sim jin tsama la yudu yore. Ten yin de, ten re ke samlo tang yun de, la tsama ke rang yin de jikwa yin yun de, ni la kare goma yin na yang, ngarang su ti rang yin yang, ti ngo yin de jor tu go yore esi. Ten yin de, ten le ngajar ten pa la go yore. Ngajar ten pa de mi songa yin na, Ini jin deh ngaran so ciram tan labar tu ciram lan daki gomyan dingji gomyan ni yurut so lan ngajar tempat tu mi semua ye na ini nyamlin te tegas aje ke je rang pin tua tu yin pin tua je yang tu ke yomare kain siwa ye na ngajar tempat tu mi semua ye na ini singlap yang tu ke yomare ngajar tempat yu semua ye na tu ni rang la pin tua ke yurut la yin simjin la pin tua tu ke yurut
And so, the first, so once you have cultivated the first point, bodhicitta, then we come to the second practice, the Yidam deity meditation. And the root verses say the true essence of the Tantra, such as Guhya Samaja, has always been innately present from the very beginning. So when we just look at the root verses, actually, the root verses explain the entire meaning. So we can learn all really by looking at the root verses. So therefore, it is really important to read those root verses, and they really are very will really support your understanding. So the deity arises from the basis of bodhicitta. So the deity therefore is the embodiment of bodhicitta, arises from bodhicitta. And then when a deity arises, it is not something that we create that has not been here before, but actually the nature of the deity is innately present as the true nature of our mind. So that is the true nature of all beings. It is the deity, but we don't recognize our nature as the deity, and that is why we are referred to as ordinary beings. So although we are innately or inherently, our nature is inherently the deity, we do not recognize this because we are obscured by various obscurations, like the obscurations of our afflictions and also the obscurations to seeing the nature of the mind and so on. So then the methods to remove those obscurations are then on page 136, four factors. There's four factors that we need to practice. And in the root text it says, coming from bodhicitta, abiding within stability, clarity, and purity. So these are the four factors. The first one is bodhicitta, from which the deity arises. So the deity arises from the basis of bodhicitta. And then secondly is says stability, clarity, and purity, those three. So actually this grouping together of stability, clarity, and purity with bodhicitta here is only for the sake of poetry, because it fits well here, but actually it's not really the stages in which we practice. So this is not the order of practice. It just for the sake of the root text, it just is all put together so we can see it all at once. But then when we actually practice it, it is not that kind of order of practice. But anyways, it is explained first in this order, even though the practice then is not that order. So first we cultivate bodhicitta, and then secondly it says the deity pride, the stability. And so here we recognize that the deity is primordially our nature. So therefore, when we visualize the deity, we are not imagining or pretending that we are the deity, but actually we are recognizing our true primordial nature as it has always been. For example, if you practice the deity Chinrizig, then you visualize your own body, yourself in the form of Chinrizig. And then actually all sentient beings have the nature of Chinrizig, and all deities have the same nature. So therefore, whichever deity you practice, since all have the same nature, you can become any of these deities. And then when you practice the deity, for deity practice, there is a visualization of oneself, and then also there is a visualization in front, the different kinds of visualizations. And so if you practice the deity without that understanding that this is your true nature, then this practice will actually be of not so much benefit to yourself and also others. And also the blessings of the deity cannot really then enter your mind. So only if this awareness is present, only if you have this deity pride, if you have this confidence of being the deity, only then actually the blessings of the deity enter your mind and you can actually become the deity.
Chi yoga na lo ni ta chi sumba te namba sarwa Ani namba sarwa te ta ngaran so hla gom ne kap la hla te sarbo che gom to go go yore si. Ani sanang thomba te ge chenpo cha go yore chiram go ya la. Ani sanang thuya la ta hla kare goma ye na yang tu so sheng de sarbo pe na. Ani ko ta jin cha la so ba te da yang te ni che rab ro wan ro sarbo me pa ma yin ba sheng de sarwa che gom go go re si. Ani te gom ne kap la yang One day, the shops could part the chasang, check gonto go yore. Tender in the jinding around so partang, tanka tang, that so gunda tang, the kains and a tada take cheater, Nabasawa yak cheater. Any tandy countries in the June the Yamlindo, Sigulan, Parndo, Tanka to Zola ta, then it make some Yanjar make ta, some tenders in the same gonto a check. And make some the necabla, making tongo go your mari, same casarbon, tontoaje, same with any shartoaje, zogo go yore. Then in the tail, number sarwa la go yore. Any teola namda temba laya jig yore, namda temba laya de tenin laka tela. Ta gandar jin chalo mambo yore, to so missing go yore. To so mimazena, any lapar to some hack la to so. Nenga zenandati, datap the mashiwala tine, any young lam lobatan do yong cigarettes. Kains and a sangha layate, chill the juncha yune sang lago yomare. Then you kanza kichi the sango rate, kanza, shirap mebu kanza to soke, any datap to so yabo mashiwachi, any telatine lam sinjo lol and jondo yatan do yongu yore. Datap layate hakogo yore. Pensun rauchi, hiwa yen up and a dorje pamochi. Then the Dorje Pamola ta pagum go yore. Pagum go laya the Tunrogum go, what Tunron and Dukiro apart. That they lag and golden jar deva china. Then this patawa in the Toshu chad yora, merging some no tang yuna. And it did that up the carriage, some no tang yundi, Dorje Pamogum go, pagum go yuate. Then the la pa laya de la Zangwat and Zoba la soba, ninzeng in Zimbata yomares. And it didn't zimba shake some what this shake some with that tela, Dorje Pamogongo, pa, congo, cha yoro. Or then in the Zami Ninzang Toba Charson with it, damsing the chaga yore. Tender in the tela, then a Namda Timba lago yore, Tenduka la chasang la, and a cashel the Tundogon gojin yore, to so Tumok Tasson with damsung chaga yore. Then it la yayomjin yore, to so Saman docha tasson with damsing chaga yore, la shedang tobog, zong yed and hang deva yore, to so then it. Shedang ta, tasong, damsing, ta teller, rerela, any, tunzi rere chaka yore, to so hako goya kitchen, but you agree.
And so then, after that, the third point is recalling the purity, and then after that, clarity. So we talked about clarity. And so then, so for the clarity is when we visualize the deity, it must appear clearly in our mind. And we must clearly visualize the deity. So a vivid visualization, whichever deity you practice. So you should visualize the deity with all its ornaments and implements and body parts very clearly. So the visualization should not be like unclear and kind of hazy, but should be very sharp and clear from the top part, the head of the deity, to the seat, to the bottom. And so for the sake of creating this clarity, we use tanka or different images, pictures of the deity. So we look at the picture, at the image, and then you close your eyes, and then again you repeat that, and then you habituate that, you meditate on this image. When you close your eyes, then you're not seeing the deity actually with your eyes, but you see the deity with the mind. So it appears within, it must appear within your mind with clarity. And then the fourth point is recalling the purity. And here it is necessary to also recognize that each of these parts of the deity, like each implement and ornament and so on, all have represent a certain meaning, a meaning of the deity's mind. And so that is important to recognize, because if we do not recognize this symbolic meaning of the deity, then it is possible that we misunderstand the deity of the secret mantra, and that might lead onto a corrupt path. And so then the secret mantra now is not secret because there is a flaw in those teachings, but it is hard to comprehend its symbolic meaning. For example, think about a deity like Vajrayogini. One of the symbolic forms of Vajrayogini is the pig's head, the sow's head. And so a pig's head is an animal. So a pig, one could say, is like the worst of animals. So then if you see it in that way, then it might seem inappropriate to put a pig's head on top of a deity. But then it actually also represents a certain meaning. The pig's head or the sow's head symbolizes that there is no grasping, no dualistic grasping to pure and impure, like a pig, without grasping at clean and dirty. So the mind is free of any grasping, any perception of pure or impure, any dualistic perception. And then there are some other deities that appear with other animal heads, for example, and that represents the purified ignorance. Or some deities appear with a consort in Yab Yum, and that represents the purified attachment. And then some deities appear wrathful, they look angry, but that represents a purified anger or hatred. So it is very important to recognize that these various symbols have a specific meaning.
Any deba mejo la soba la chinkor tan la ge la soba be yin sang go re si ene karse te da ma zena la den rogu ma re si san rogu tong a yang jung go re si sang ha la ya de yin na ene mambu che si che nyin ge yo ma re la nam je tu dang ko war se pe te ni nga da wa che yang long tam ge par ma chu song do la ba da la drupa se ne ka la nyin pa mambu dōnggō gō yōre. Nyēnpān dōngwēn ēkā lā kēchā xiexie tāng nyēnpān dōng xie sēm nāmbō gō bārat chū dēwā yēnā lā tēn dōbyā lā thā rīngbō chāng dō gō yōre ēsi. Tēndē yīndē ēnī sēm māntō wā gō chī tā ēnī tīngiñ zēng lā nēpā gō nī tēnī yīn lā kēchā mā xie wā ngā jē nē ēnī sēm tsē chīk tā nēpā gō nī lā ngā dā gō gō rē ēsi. Tēnī tendri sewa yena sem de tingin jeng na ne songa yena ani la ten do ya la tha nyo yo re song de te song ga song ya bare
so then on page 140 in the English it says, keep the practice secret and invoke the awakened mind with the mantra recitation, then you will accomplish the essential nature. And the practice must be concealed or kept secret from those who are not proper vessels for those teachings. And so these are those people who have not seen the mandala, or in other words, have not received the empowerment. So the empowerment or the sacred substances and so on, the mandala must be then kept hidden from them. So for those who are not a proper vessel. And if one fails to do so, it says this will hinder our accomplishment of the deity, and also actually we incur a downfall of broadcasting the secret teachings. And so then we recite the mantra. When we, in order to accomplish the deity, we must complete mantra accumulation, a certain number of mantra accumulation. And while we do so, while we recite the mantra, we should not interrupt this mantra recitation with other conversation, with idle talk, and so on. Because if we interrupt the recitation with other conversation, then we distance ourselves from the accomplishment of the deity. So while we recite the mantra of the deity, we should do so single-pointedly and while remaining silent, without engaging in any talk, any conversation. Then if we practice with such a single-pointed samadhi, then we approach, we step closer to accomplishing the deity.
Yani tsatsik pela tada de sangha me ne chang ma ja ja ga ma re ji sangha ke tada yedang la de so nyam ni ma je wa yin na yani ngara zo sanje ji koma thug ma re so ndo e de ge tsatsik ge na lo la de mi so de nga de nyam ni ma je wa yin na ngudop thug ma re se ngudop thug ma re la de sanje ji koma thug ma re se yani de le dem re thop se nga nyam ni se wa yin na de ba sanje ji koma thug re so ne tsatsik ge tong da de so yong ge yo re Tata Nindrava Ganalo la Sarbushu Sondo Pen Tap Parra the Simba Tolong Aransu Yamni Seva Yena Yang Any Punkam Chimchi Tamardan Zimb Toba Tang Travis Shira Mina Tang Jagamare Sondoa Pen Aransu Dene lead the Yadam Gla need the Magoma Yena and Aransu lead the Tamarwa need the Zane and Yamni Kase Seva Yena Yang Sanji Koma Top to Yomares. They in the Tata Naranzo can tong dewan deso tamarwa tong dewatan, Naranzo litian tini, tamar will linge the tong dewan de pa jongo yore. The junya la, jirem la namjur gongo yore, the jirem gongish, jimsin yeshe soa. The yak the gom done. Tini, the yak gom the jirem la namjur the yusuma yena. Any Naranzo and nang dewa ke yordan, ta dewa da. Any tamar ge shimba to tama pa don rogu yore. De doya ge nimbo de la tada de gongo yore. Jungzi, jirem la naba de gongo yore. Any jungzi jirem la naba gong yundi rang yedam ge la ye go song tok yundi teleje rovan yi de chan rogu yore. Tende cha songa yena, any ranya yedam la langajar tempo zon tok rang lunga yi som yedam la ngon yi de chor songa yena. Any soy parche da nanga parche la soba kayan yunya yomarech. Yadam layate, any ta parche samal jar savare, parche samal and dead savacha de yore. And tendugal nyamni si toa tubuneka la, doyula long jejan sanje and chupa chando grace, rang lit the yadam linga yexumbote, yadam lang oni the chorsumayena, any samasavatang, ta kares seva yena yang, any yadam lal and chupa chando yore. Lapart and doyong chila kase longjiwa yena yan nipe kya yo mares. Any tad namjorpa layat so cha yung yore, toba the dempa kanza lan. And kandar doyong chi tang jinding arang so mugewalet se deya to so kandar longjiwa yena yang. Any sa ya toba yishi konden prayag jachando yore, toba yishi konden prayag jachando ma toba ke deg ma toba yishi de nyamya chi chaga yo mares. Sanje Jomdin de Song Yore, Na Laya de Tam Kebares, Tam Kebogon in Yamlin Nankures, Bernan Hima Jagala, Jabri Cup Laya to Yore, Jabri Cup Troncher, and the Troncher Nalo La Tam Masanga, Masanga Pe Mambo Yores, Jabri Cup Tronchella, Troncher Gemini, Jabri Cup Troncher than that, any Masanga Pombo Runan Yua, and the so Masanga Nasu Pa Torza Chad Yore, Chitan Sevayena. And to so shinkala loa yena, shen getini loto lasoba dea, jizzi, deso jizzi gjo, mimpi jizzi gjo yantaba chaka yores. Tang around to the kala organic food lamidae, de chano yur kala ya hit chagdoa. Oh, de in the nyomumba to so dina yin sancho semdan, sanjeg yundin jizila, pinto yores on yavare. No yung chil longju shiva yena, then it tender seva yena, so bad the meba zoba zobatang. Chow Tumong Drop Sanje Komante Nyot Drop Togres on the Tesson Yavare.
So it says then without practicing the Yidam deity of secret mantra, one cannot fully attain enlightenment. So in the root text it says, without it, the secret mantra, there can be no cities. So there is no result of enlightenment that can be attained. And only from it, from the secret mantra practice, the result of Buddhahood is attained. So when we practice the Yidam deity, the purpose of visualizing our body in the form of the Yidam deity is in order to purify our ordinary perception of the body, seeing ourselves as ordinary. So even if we practice the other five perfections, without the wisdom that realizes, that does not grasp at the body, the aggregates and the sensory fields as mundane or as ordinary, we will not become Buddhas, we will not become enlightened. So for as long as we see our body and our sense sources and so on as ordinary, we cannot attain enlightenment. So it is this ordinary perception that we need to purify in order to attain enlightenment. And so for that purpose, in order to purify that, we visualize the deity, the creation stage. So we visualize the deity according to those four factors that we have mentioned before. So the creation stage becomes the one that purifies ordinary perception. That is the ordinary perception of forms of objects and also of sounds. And so instead of clinging to things as ordinary, then we, by visualizing the deity, we arise as the enlightened body, speech, mind, qualities and activities of the deity. And when we arise in this way, then all the outer and inner obstacles will be cleared away. This will turn around all obstacles, so obstacles will not arise. And so then once one has transcended all obstacles, one has become the nature of the deity, one's body, speech and mind appears as the deity, then even if one enjoys any of the sense pleasures, it will only become an offering to the deity. Whatever one does becomes an offering to the deity. And that is because there is no grasping in the mind. So that is now from the perspective of an realized and accomplished yogin, in whose mind there is no grasping, no attachment. And so then from that perspective, from the perspective of such a realized yogin, and even activities that are normally non-virtues actually become an enhancement to that yogin's realization of the primordial wisdom. And they do not become a cause of decline or transgression. So that is the skillful means that of secret mantra that the Buddha had taught. For example, there was a story about this place in India, Khenpo Samdup, not the name in Sanskrit now, but anyways, this place, there was this mountain of filth, of like garbage. And so actually, when you look at it like that, it's like a mountain of garbage, but actually scraps and this mountain of filth actually can also be used for plowing a field, for preparing a field, and then it becomes actually the best basis for growing crops. So it is like organic food, for example. It's the best food, grows from the dirt, actually, from like the scraps and the garbage. So just like that, to a realized yogin, to them, the afflictions and the sense pleasures that arise, because they arise on the basis of bodhicitta, become actually an enhancement to the cultivation of the enlightened qualities. And therefore, in this way, it says such a yogin therefore can perfect the accumulations and attain the two siddhis, the common and sublime siddhis, quickly.
The garbage is not the plastic, okay? It's come from the humans and the animals. So that's put in the field, right? So then you get good crop. Yeah. 대지 다 되니 검수치 응아래 다 손바 대 자기도 손바 찌름도 내면 아니 용된 탐지 용내 라마 공고 그래. 얘네 라마 공야 대라 다 자세는 대성 용고 요리 응급 자와 왕게 잡어대 생급 라야대 산재 공방 토바들 응급 대그 자와대 가르쳐도 요아리 라나 다 근도 탐지 용은 너무 나인 대 라마 담바레스 왕게 잡어대 라야대 라마 라 Labko Yure. Then it lamad layate gongoya kechimbo chade yores, kains and novenan yeres. Novotele gundu tamjin yuanan yi. Then it ngaran soke yu la yondin chiegona, lama latini yondin chasan chiegomato, lama mina, and yondin chia yomares. Lama maple corona, sanje sava mayami, song yore. Lama maple corona, sanje layate yomares. Then the Yonti Tamjig and Yonghong, the Lama Chaka Yodi Lama, the Yijin Nova Nigeria is on the Pejayare.
And so then, next is the third Dharma. So then we have visualized the deity, and so within the state of being the deity, then we also must meditate on the Guru, who is the source of all good qualities. So then the root text says, the Lama is the root of the cities, king of the empowerments. The cities here refers to state of enlightenment. So the Guru is the root of enlightenment, and the king of the empowerments here refers to the Guru, that is the Guru. So the Guru is the root of all city or of accomplishment. And it is very important to practice the Guru because he is the source of all good qualities and therefore like a wish-fulfilling jewel. And that means that if we have a guru, we rely on a guru, we can develop the qualities of enlightenment. Without a guru, we cannot develop any qualities, we cannot develop the qualities of enlightenment. So it is therefore said that without a guru present, there can also be no enlightenment. So therefore, the guru is like a wish-fulfilling jewel.
Ene lama te tni kane si dogur lana ta yong nalo la song yore sanje ning tong kusom jarb ter songda lama laya te la ene sanje ni den tong go ne tni rang dangal shogo gure te ma to lama sosi chio ni den tong song ayena ene rang gudok kanya thugumare. Lama tepen sanju sampan dao chi lan thong ne teni ngarang su dama chiwa yina ngudop chungze chik thukure si ngudop thamo chik thukure lan ngudop chungze thukure si lama sanje ngisun thomu go ne ene dama chiwa yina ta ngarang su gu ju la teni ngudop chodo chowa ta sanje yung ting tu su che gure sonu te song yawa re ene lama laya de sanje chik den zibu ngoo nye te shi sona yung ting pa dame ban jong son doa.
And so then next is how to actually accomplish, how to practice the Lama, the Guru. And in the root text it says, see the Lama as the actual Buddha, the treasury of the three Kayas. So we should receive the instructions of the Guru, of the Lama, seeing the Guru as the actual Buddha. Because if we receive the instructions while we only see the Guru as an ordinary person, then we will not attain any siddhis at all. And if you see the Lama as a Bodhisattva, when you receive the instructions, then you will attain small siddhis. And if you see the Lama as the Buddha, while you receive the instructions, you will attain the highest supreme siddhi. And so that is the attainment of enlightenment. And so therefore, when we practice the Guru, while we receive the instructions, we should see the Guru as the actual Buddha.
Lama tela ta mugi dan tenpa ngani gom gogo yore. Lama la mugi mi sama yina sing lam jogo yomare. Te manjowa te lama kubya kaara la si lama ta kaara na yin. Mugi te mugi ke nyama ma sha na si. Tene mugi te nyama na yin re si. Tene sing lam la ya te chujo na yin re. Nyama te kaara la sha yon deka la kaara te sha yon go yora. Tene na yin. Tene mugi yuwa yin na lama ke yoni sing lam jogo yore si. Ini tentunya tak dempeng ngani lama tak gonggu yurut. Lama gong di lama kawa gonggu lama. Ini so zopan doa omeng jenis so gong lab yurut. Omeng layak te cewa lo gonggu re. Seranjik so nama so zogo yuna. Ini lama cewa kita no gonggu re. rang sem gu ne lo de to gu gu yuna de ni lama de nyin ka lo gong gu gu yure ene rang de ba to so pa ta go de che de lama go ma yena ene lama te wa la gom so ne de ni gom sar de ne khani song ya ba re ne so no gong gu gu re so mu yure lama
So then when we practice them, the guru, when we accomplish the guru, what is essential is to develop devotion. Without developing devotion to the guru, we can also not receive the blessings. So the blessings are the source, the devotion is the source of all blessings. In the verses of realization, it says in this fivefold path, so that the sun of devotion must shine on the snow mountain of the guru's four kayas. So the snow mountain is the guru, and the sun is the devotion. And so when the sun shines on the snow mountain, it will melt the snow. And when the snow melts, a current of a river emerges. And so that current is the blessings. So the sun of devotion melts the snow mountain, and the current of blessings emerges. And so then, having cultivated devotion, then we visualize the Lama. And so there are three different places where we can visualize the Lama. If you want to accumulate merit, then you should visualize the Lama above the crown of your head, which is also called this place is the pure land of Akanishta, or says Ogmin here. So you visualize at the crown of your head and think that this is where the pure land of Akanishta is. And so then if, on the other hand, you want to realize the nature of the mind, then you should visualize the Lama in your heart center. And the corresponding, which represents the corresponding pure land. And then if you want to purify a faults or obscurations, and then you should meditate on the Lama in your navel center.
The Lama la mugi mi soma yena, any meg me bada na yere, si ming mi sondoa. Mugi yuwa yena, meg denba na yere, songu yore. Meg dan dena, en garan su, ta mantongwa taso pan tongwa cha yungu yore. En di na yi dripa pang rogu yore, si mugi yuwa yena. Mugi mi na dripa pang togu mare, songya te tonda re. En di o la ta gonza chi nga ga na lo ni, yipa Donji Nimbo Nelo Saja Chimbo Gon Layata de Nimbo Rao Chaga Yure Saja Chimbo de. And it Jirum Zoram Layan Yiganalo ni the Zoram Chaga Yure Saja Chimbo de Nelo Saja Chimbo. And it Saja Chimbo de la Ta Donji Nimbo Sungu Yure Nadin Nagan Nadin Ganalo ni Nimbo de Na Tavate Saja Chimbo Chada Yore. A Saja Chimbo de Tada Yong Ganalo ni Tatsig La Duni Machin Katan Demase Sungu Yure. Saja Chimbo Layate, Rangus, Semte Chagayore, Semte Domani Chiwameba. Then in Nangata of Chapjing, Demasebranji. Any Uta Wusara Tomani Sondo Saja Chimbo Layate, Tendejila, Tani Tago Gre, Siteson Yavare.
As it is said that devotion is like gaining sight, like eyesight. And without devotion, one is like a blind person. So in order to purify obscurations, we need therefore to cultivate devotion. Because when there is sight, then we purify obscurations. So without eyesight, we cannot purify obscurations. So we need to cultivate devotion. And then on the basis of that, we come to the fourth point, which is Mahamudra. And that is actually the essence of the fivefold path. And it is the practice of the true nature of reality, Mahamudra, of the two stages, the creation and completion stages. The Mahamudra belongs to the completion stage, is the completion stage. And in a root text, it says, primordially unborn like the sky, unconditioned. So Mahamudra, it refers to the nature of one's own mind. And it is the unborn and all-pervasive, space-like nature of the mind. It is unconditioned. It is natural luminosity emptiness. And so that is that nature, which is the nature of mind, is given the name Mahamudra. And so then next is explains the actual nature of the mind as it is, what is the characteristic of the nature of the mind. It says it is all pervasive and like a vajra, unchanging and always present. So the characteristic of the nature of the mind is, its defining characteristic is that it is an all pervasive nature. It pervades all of samsara and nirvana. So when it is the one that creates samsara, that pervades samsara, and also it is the basis of nirvana. It is all is the mind. Samsara and nirvana both is the mind, and it is like a vajra because it is indestructible and invincible, and that is wherever you go in the six realms of samsara, nothing can change this nature. Nothing can destroy this nature. Even if you're born in hell, although you experience unbearable suffering there, still none of that can destroy or change the nature of the mind. Or if you're born as a human being and you experience the suffering of birth, old age, illness, and death, and you're afflicted by anger and jealousy and pride and so on, none of these concepts can destroy the nature of the mind. It is always unchanging in the three times, unbound by the three linear times. So this mind itself is what we call Mahamudra.
Saja chimbo layate, namda res, namda imbe jimsin de, teni, ye domani nabar tapare, sung yuri, draba pangoya tende, y koran semg nelo, draba yomarese, nabar tapare, teni wusawa tontamba sancho semi endeva, sungjo la piure, sungjo layate, teni kinzo da tondam, kakala, deni sungjo yan la piure, nyamjata jitom zo nisegure, ten nisemeba. Tovat ke tonda tela songjo la ko yore ene saja chimbi ton la ya te ta manda ba ton chin na saja yeng song yore manda ba la de ene khowa ta nyang in de le manda ba ton chin na saja ene tel kong de yin ya tel cho de chwa me bi jim sin ji chimbo la ko yore saja chimbi tonda de ten re ji lan de she she ko yore se
And then the root text says, it describes the categorizations, innately pure, indivisible, the essence of Mahamudra. So innately pure, Mahamudra is innately pure. That is, the nature of the mind is pure, primordially pure. That is, by nature, its nature is always free of obscurations. So the nature of the mind is luminosity and clarity. clarity. So it is also indivisible, or it is a state of union, which refers to the realization of non-duality, the non-duality of the two truths, or of samsara and nirvana. It is the realization of non-duality, this indivisible, or indivisible union. And then the term Mahamudra itself, mudra here refers to, it says we can never go outside or beyond this nature. So it means, mudra means that it is sealed, nothing can go beyond it. And samsara or nirvana both are not beyond the nature of the mind, nothing goes beyond it. And then maha means great, so there is no higher realization than the realization of the nature of mind.
So then how
can we realize the nature of the mind? It is when we practice based on the Lama's instructions. So we must receive the instructions and then also practice according to these instructions. If we do not practice according to these instructions, there's no other method to realize the nature of the mind. So that is the only way to realize the nature of the mind. So we must practice or meditate according to these instructions. And once we have recognized Mahamudra, then we might encounter various circumstances, like various thoughts and emotions might arise, or we encounter various obstacles or all sorts of experiences manifest and so on. So when all of these difficulties arise, then we must take these on the path. And that is when we rest in Mahamudra, in a state of Mahamudra, the natural state of the mind, then all these arisings, whatever it is that arises, whatever difficulty, is like a wave on the ocean that dissolves, arises and then dissolves back into the water. This is how we take the difficult circumstances as the path. So if you later have time and you read through the commentary here, it is actually very clear, so then you will understand on how to take that as the path.
And Timrim Lasoba Songyo Negala, Nyamlin de Sindone, Gandarta, Pardola Sangje, Mambochi, Rombochi Terrensons, what to do younger yores. Tate, Tinni Tiola, Tep Jadang up to Nakik and Alola, Tope, Namdon, Zimbe, Siparching, Sondote, Saja Chimbo Song Yung Yore. Toss on the Tron Dogres, Zains on the Tinning Covenant, Cheng Dogres, Gang Ton the Tinning Covat and Yangland de Bichi Tamje, Demase, Lynch to Barawa, Songyo Saja Chimbe Nello to Toss on Yena, and his Sanjay Coma Tom Dog Yore, Songyo Saja Chimbe Nello to Matone. Any Zoma than Zimbany, the Shin Songayan, Covenants and Chamdogres on a Tesson Yavare. Any Nyande than Kora Laya, New York, Nyande Laya de, any Semgunello Tovatel and Nyande. Any Kora Laya de, Zunzang is a Shin Songatel and Kora Lamna to this cheaper segures.
And so later you can read through that. Next is knowing how to bring death on the path. We're going through this whole commentary now, so you can read that more thoroughly later to understand. And so, just in brief, whatever arises, whatever circumstance, whether it is a positive or negative arising, whatever arises, we take it as onto the path. According to how it is explained here, and by resting in the natural state of the mind. And so if we practice that while we are alive now, then later when we die, and when the process of dissolution begins, then we will know how to engage in practice here. And then as Rinpoche explained today, there's different levels of attaining enlightenment in the various stages of the bardo then. So you can finish reading that later. And then on page 152, it says, realization brings you freedom. Grasping keeps you stuck in samsara. So when you realize the nature of mind, you are liberated. When you hold on to the grasping mind, and then you're stuck in samsara. You're pulled down, you're tied down to samsara. When you realize Mahamudra, you're enlightened, and if you cling to the subject-object duality, to perceiving things in a subject-object dualistic way, then that is what will keep you stuck wandering in samsara. There is this division between samsara and nirvana. So nirvana is when to realize the nature of the mind, and samsara is to cling to a subject-object duality.
Ani dong yik drusu nyumong yishi te songgu yore. Te yinde ta, dea nyumong lam chere songgu yore, nyumong lam da chere sorgu kani songgu yore. En nyumong laya te, ta sosu jiwo le tangbo pa, kapsa panza cha de yore. Data of Tagore is in Yamonga. Any that Yate is a toba julice yon then and up Sancho send the commune king of Kanzayena. Any Yamong to so John of your Jor Pong Jor Sung your John of yours. Yamon but to so pa John some hinging over in the John of your Lamb the Cherries of your Ha in a Lamb the Chandra of your Yamon Lamb Cherries on your. Any day in the tender Yamlin number song can in Roger Yore. Tada the solo Jetan the Pesha Yong Nalone, Zuba takes Yore. Labart and Jigtin Sungung Gombate, and then Yamong Yishis Jor Layat and Dick Yomares. Jor Layate, Yamong Korang Jorgo Mares. Penangarang so Sosichi Ote, then Sanje Lapa, Jor Lam and Dick Yomares. Naranzo yet domani Sanje and overchad yores. Jorgoya yomar tamboni Sanje chad yore. And today in the Kantar Naranzo Julio Nyomoba, the sopa Karzog Pang done, and it says same nello the ter Nusa in the Togo grace. Tendrici song your Gonjig and Alola. Day in the Tada dig and Alola. Nyamong lamcher la, ini nyamong ngate yishig ngola jol gogre song ya chik song yore jol lande kandar disong yore pong jol lande se ba so so ya ta nyamong te pong wa mare churwa jol pong wa jurwa te tex tengum te jol tambo samno chik tang de gongje na kare song yo I want to thinking about the gongjing. Forget the gongjing. What in the gongjing says? Jigten Sumgon talk something in the gongjing. Nyamong. That's the George.
So here we're talking then about taking the afflictions as the path. And the next verse says, poison is nectar, the kleshas are wisdom. And so there's three different ways to give up the affliction. So first, for beginning practitioners first abandon the affliction. So they see the afflictions like an enemy. And then after having done some practice and having cultivated some bodhicitta, then the afflictions, second then, are transformed through love and compassion. And then thirdly, according to the Vajrayana, the afflictions are taken as the path. So there is these three ways of practicing with the afflictions. And so there is some debate in the different scriptures about that. And actually, now Jigten Sumgon, according to Jigten Sungan's tradition, it says that Jigten Sumgon says that actually we cannot actually say that the afflictions are transformed into wisdom. It is actually not proper to say that, because there is nothing to be transformed actually. And also it is not proper to say that an ordinary being is transformed into a Buddha, becomes a Buddha, because we already are Buddhas by nature primordially. We never actually become Buddhas. So in the Gongchik, it is by Jigten Sumgon, it is explained in such a way. How we take the afflictions as the path is by recognizing the nature of the mind. And so by recognizing the nature of the mind, the afflictions are, as it is explained here, taken as the path.
The translator talk very good way. Explain. I forget the Gongchi words, but he talk all the meanings there. So, there is that. So the your life, the kind of transform life, the degree you are receiving, transform goya you are receiving. So, yet domani sanje chado yora. Main pala yimpa jor go yore se wa transform la ya to main pa te yimpa chil jor go yore se te goya yo mare se te ni ta pang te kelen ke yosan ji tin sungong ke pang la ya te nyomong ge drba to so pa pang ne te ni sanje gra ji ni sungong to jo yong gre so na te ni yin sa re te ni re ma we did the gonchek translator, you remember? Chu ji sa song, he also forget. It's okay. Yeah. We don't have time to log. So anyway, the Jigten Sumgon says not transforming, you know. Because we already Buddha. I'm beginning last time, we are all Buddha. No need to transform to the Buddha. So it's needed to purify obscurations. Purify, not transforming. Some says need to transform, but Jigten Sumgon says no need to transform. We already Buddha, then, you know, I'm beginning last time. So all sentient beings is a Buddha, right? Need to purify it. Like same is the sun. Sun is no need to transform to the sun, right? So need to purify the clothes, right? So like that way, that has a very good reason. Ta nyamong ga de yishi ga le mong pa rang yi de shi song yin de yishi chang de yore se. Pa ne xie dang le ta yong ne ga la xie dang korang ma do pa. Xie dang korang ngo wo xie song yin de dor ji sen pa ngo wo ni de chang de yore. Me long yishi la gu yo ma re.
Dor ji sen pa.
Ta 다들 자바랭가도 요소를 망보 요래 간다 카셰르 도르지 선발라고 요래 제당 답부 차라 도르지 선바스러와 니몽 답부 차라 데니 자바 오빠미 라네 데니 파타 답부 차니 야노라
도차그라
도차 다들 근데 카셰 그 니몽 데 파 존네 에니 오빠미 차르 좀 요래 다단데 니몽 그 마로번 그 차니 자바 오빠미 저 드네서 야고 그 요래
So the point is that the afflictions are actually, the five afflictions to actually not transform into the five wisdoms. It says the essence of these afflictions has always abided as the five wisdoms. So we only simply need to recognize the nature of these afflictions. And for example, there is actually no real anger. So we need to recognize the actual nature of this anger that arises. And when you only recognize its basic nature, then the anger, for example, is referred to as this Buddha Vajrasattva or the mirror-like wisdom. And so any of the five Dhyani Buddhas corresponds to an affliction. For example, attachment is Amitabha. And some others say that when the affliction, like when attachment transforms, it becomes Amitabha. So, but here actually it says it doesn't become Amitabha, it already is that nature, if you recognize the nature of the affliction.
Any gom the chingak nalolinga bata gave it our yendo nhoate song yung yore. The young nalol, mumten chunda, gendu nankunzu, sonda. That gave it our jachimbosa yawate, sanchoks, mangina, and in zendro yore, said that sanjejo coma to yakchi the hog of yore, sancho the hola de. The mangina, and it gets at the sendro yore, and the shedang shokimboje yung negala gets at the jomro yore. Kabaton the sabayan, compro check in jomban yors on the chunyun and song yore. ခုံတို့ကြည့်ကြည့်ရုံနဲ့ကလည်းကပတုံးတစားရောက်ကြတဲ့ဆိုချက်ဆံကြုံတော့ကလေးစတဲ့တဲ့ငဝဲမှာစင်ပြေကြတဲ့ဆိုကြုံတော့ကလေးဆုံးကြရတယ်အဲတဲ့ရင်တဲ့တာရောက်လို့ငဝတဲ့ကောကြရတယ်အဲဒီငဝတဲ့တဲ့ဆန်ချုပ်စင်ကြည့်လာရတဲ့ရင်တော့ရောရတယ်ငဝကြည့်ပွားတော့ရဒေါချာထားတဲ့ချာတဲ့ရတယ်တာဆန်ချုပ်စင်လာရတဲ့ငဲတဲ့ရင်ကြဲပစာကန်းဒုပတ်တဲ့ဆိုတဲ့နင်းစင်ချင်းထမ်းကြည
And so then after that, after having having abandoned the afflictions, and then realized Mahamudra, then we come to the fifth point, the dedication. And the dedication is these virtues that we have practiced are dedicated then for the benefit of other sentient beings. And so the vast dedication is a dedication with a mind of bodhicitta. And only if we dedicate our roots of virtue, the roots of virtue will become vast. Otherwise, if we do not properly dedicate them, then they can become destroyed. They it says they are subject to depletion. They can go out of existence. When anger arises, anger can destroy all our roots of virtue if we do not dedicate them. In the Bodhicharya Avatara, the Shantideva prayer, it says, the virtues accumulated in 1,000 aeons is destroyed by a single moment of hatred. And so that is when we do not dedicate our virtue, they can become destroyed. And so the nature of the dedication actually is essentially the same as the motivation of bodhicitta in the beginning. So they are the same in terms of their essence. Dedication and motivation are the same. It is the essence is love, loving kindness and compassion. It is bodhicitta. And then where they differ is in terms of the timing. In the beginning, we look into the future. So in the future, for the benefit of all beings, I'm going to engage in this practice. And then in the end, we are like we're looking back at the roots of virtue, and we dedicate them for sentient beings.
Okay, so dedication is the same as you save the, your files right in the computer. So otherwise, all going to lost. You close the computer, you lost all the tapings, your work, right? So we need to save. Any questions? Yes. You mean the teacher?
Yeah, the teacher gives a direct introduction.
Yes, the yesterday empowerment is a direct introduction. Also today, Mahamudra is a direct introduction, really. Yeah. If the disabled student recognize, you know, understanding.
So, you know, I was thinking in terms of like the three statements of Arab
Dorje. Yes.
Is there something like this here that is clearly stated?
This is a different path, you know, Fivefold Mahamudra. The three statement is just only introduction directly, right? This one has more path. Yeah. Step by step. This is Mahamudra section is directly introduction. Yeah. Needed to more meditations then. Yeah. The dependent person, you know. Some needed to more sitting meditation, silent meditation, some doing practicing more yadam deity practicing, you know, dependent person. You can you want to know the whole experience comes, right? Understanding, yeah? Yeah, just all experience comes from the meditation. If no doing meditation, no experience. So if you're not going any place, you stay here, you cannot see outside, right? You drive, you can see nice house, maybe trees, lakes, kind of mountains. Same thing, you know, you do meditation, you have experiencing. But you cannot attach to the experiencing. Yes.
I really like that sentence, take the affliction as the path. But how do you do that in meditation? Hearing the words that I'm not.
You mean afflictions?
Take the affliction as the path. You're sitting in meditation and then an affliction arises and you're just looking at it. I'm asking how to do those words.
Actually, this is doing like practice in many different ways, depending on the person's situation. You know, you're doing the sitting meditation, then you arise the afflictive emotions. So you just recognize that, and then you stay in the Mahamudra, the all afflictive emotions become kind of just go away or reduce, right? Purified. So that means that afflictive emotions take to the path. Your question is like that?
Kind of.
Then the reason, you know? The reason, you know?
Oh, yeah.
So, I think it's a many different, you know, ways to take to the path, depending on our situation, right? Like, which kind of, like, you want to take the path, like, you give me some example, maybe.
Do you mean?
Yeah, that's also just take to the path means like not become obstacles. It's more benefit to practicing. We talk about the same as the garbage, right? Take put in the fields and become more crop comes, right? Like that way. Actually, you have anger, you know. Anger is good to practicing. When anger arises, then you lock the anger. Anger is naturally, you know, it's the
It naturally, like, it dissolves on its own, naturally dissolves.
See, that is become practicing, you know, path. Anger is take to the path. Yes?
So in prayer to Kunzi Jangpo, when anger arises, it says relax naturally at ease.
Yeah, this is a take to the path, yes?
And is that kind of what you're talking about as you saw the, you know, all of the afflictions? You know,
yes, yeah.
Kunzi Jangpo prayer.
Yeah.
You know, it says instead of following it and making it bigger or whatever.
Yes.
Relax.
Relax.
Watch it and either go away or.
Go away, yeah. Yes. It's same thing, you know. Yeah, not similar, it's the same, exactly same. Yes.
Yeah, you told that in order to relax the nature of the mind when practice Guru Yoga, you should visualize the Guru at the heart center. You know, you can visualize on top of your head if you want to get married. If you want to realize the nature of the mind in the heart.
Yeah.
If you want to purify oscillation in the nerve.
Yes.
But is it possible to realize the nature of the mind just visualizing in the heart without first cleaning oscillation? There is an order of that, or I can just realize the nature of the mind without purifying oscillation or accumulating mind?
Yeah, I think you can do just four places, you know, everywhere you can meditate. Depending, you know, when you're going to meditation, you need to visualize in the heart center, right?
Yeah.
So when you're going to do some prostrations, making accumulations, Guru is dropping the here, and you Vajrasava, thinking about, you know, different.
Yeah. Another question. Yeah. When I visualize my Guru, my root Guru is catching
me. Yeah.
Of course, I only see him maybe once a year, possibly. But when I visualize him in my heart, I can visualize the physical body of Gachan Rinpoche, or for example, Vajradhara symbolizing Gachan Rinpoche. You know, what are the image, you know, what picture should I put?
So you say, you seeing the Gachan Rinpoche?
Yeah, okay. I want to practice Guru Yoga. I need to visualize my Guru here.
Yes.
Gachan Rinpoche. But to visualize the picture of Gachan Rinpoche, or for example, Vajradhara meaning Gachan Rinpoche. What shape? You know the shape.
Karasiwa. Tekun lama gom kono. Ya karamaj ko lama yena ko lama karamaj gom gorba nikala. Ni kurang ti bena ko karamaj pa nang shin rwa karamaj tumba da bo. Tina gom gorbe sa yena ta ben to je chang karamaj gom bo ni ba.
Nene sa na yedam gla de tsaw lama ngo yin ba la gu yura. La gram ji tene tsaw lama ngo yin ba gom de gu yura.
So we say that the Yidam deity has the nature of the guru. So you can visualize the form of the Yidam deity, your Yidam deity, and then the essence of your guru.
Actually, both is okay. No separable, you know, Yidam Lama and the Yidam is the same. No separable, yeah. So your mind, the Lama, Yidam, three of no separable. It's the same.
So I'm afraid I'm a little confused. So is deity practice a separate practice to Mahamudra?
Actually, this five-part Mahamudra is, you know, is separate, right? But when you practice in Yidam deity, you have realization Mahamudra then practicing is very strong benefit for other beings, benefit to practitioner, you know. Not really need to separate, but teaching time is they all different, right? Do you understand? There was the Tadang Ading Gomrawa. Ading Gom Dingness and the Lam Rambana Yin Yamni Sidan Song Yurmato, Paka Saja Chimbi Toba Jul Denkin, you know. And Yadam Kalan Yamni Sivinagal Saja Chimbi Toba Tobangan in Yamni Nangro Yur, Saja Chimbi Toba Kangani. Toba Tingan Yamni Nangro Yura.
Yeah, so normally we practice the fivefold path in stages, but then once one has realized Mahamudra, then within that state actually that state itself has the nature of the Yidam, so it is all complete within that state of the of Mahamudra.
Okay, thank you everybody. Good night. See you tomorrow. Thank you, Inala.